Today we're going to migrate Hassio from a Raspberry Pi and install it on Docker containers in a Linux machine. I'm going to show you step by step how you can set up an Ubuntu server, set up Docker, install Hassio on Docker containers, and last but not least, we're going to set up Portainer so you can manage all the containers installed. Alright, so to set up an Ubuntu server in a computer, we need to download the server image from the Ubuntu website and create a bootable drive. You can find a link for everything that we're going to be using in the description below. For those of you that already know how to set up an Ubuntu server or already have one set up, you can skip the steps by going to this part of the video. Okay, let's go to the Ubuntu website and download the server image. Then to create a bootable drive, we are going to use Etcher, which makes it super simple to flash the image to a USB stick. When you open Etcher, click on Select Image and select the Ubuntu ISO file that was downloaded. If you only have one USB drive connected to the computer, Etcher automatically selects that drive. Lastly, click on Flash and give it a couple of minutes. Okay, the bootable drive is ready to go. Now let's connect it to the computer where we want to install the Ubuntu server. When you turn on your computer, it should automatically boot from the USB stick. However, if it doesn't, you will need to access the boot menu to select the drive that you want to boot from. As soon as you boot the computer, on the first screen that you get, you should be able to see the key that you need to press to access the boot menu. Alright, so once you are in the Ubuntu installation, select the language, the keyboard layout, then select Install Ubuntu. On the network connections, leave it as DHCP, so the router can assign the configuration automatically. However, on your router, you want to make sure that you set up a static IP address for your server. So like that, the server always gets the same IP address. That's something that I won't be covering here because all routers are different. You will need to check with your router's manufacturer to learn how to do it. The proxy configuration, leave it empty. And for the Ubuntu archive mirror, leave it as default. For the file system setup, we are going to be using the whole drive, so select Use an entire disk. If you have more than one drive installed, select the drive that you want to perform the installation. Then click on Done and Continue. Next, set up a profile, so enter your name, the server name, a username, and a password. Because the server is going to be a headless machine, meaning that no monitor will be connected to it, we want to make sure that we select Install Open SSH Server, so we can remotely connect from another computer. Lastly, under Features Server Snaps, leave it as it is and click on Done to complete the installation. When the installation finishes, click on Reboot Now and remove the bootable USB drive. Alright, so the Ubuntu server is now up and running, and we can access it via SSH from another computer. So let's go ahead and do that to continue the installation remotely. On your computer, open the terminal and type SSH, the username, then add, and the IP address for your server. Then press Enter and type Yes to continue with the connection. Now, before doing the rest of the installation, update the packages on the Linux server with sudo apt-get update. Then upgrade the packages using sudo apt-get upgrade. Before installing Docker, we need to set up some additional packages, but first we want to get root access, so type the command sudo-i. Then enter the following command to install the packages. Then add the Docker's official GPG key with the following. After that, we need to verify that we have the key with this fingerprint. So search for the last 8 characters of the fingerprint with this command. Now we need to add the repository where we are going to get Docker from. There are 3 different channels, stable, nightly, and test. We definitely want to get the stable version, so enter this command. Alright, everything is ready, so we can now install Docker with the following. Then to verify that Docker was installed correctly, we can run the Hello World image. The last thing that we want to do before installing Hassio is to make sure that Docker starts when the server boots. So type systemctl enable Docker. Alright, so Docker is up and running, and if for some reason the server is rebooted, Docker is going to restart automatically. Now, to install Hassio, we need to install a few more required packages, so on the terminal, enter the following. After that is done, we can install Hassio with this command. And that's it. Give it like a minute or two and Home Assistant will be ready to go. And you can access the front end using the server's IP address with the port 8123 at the end. Okay, so we now have Home Assistant all set and we can start configuring it as we usually would. We can also restore the configuration from a backup. So if you had Hassio already installed on another device, you could create a backup there and save it to your computer. Then on this new installation, you can set up the Samba add-on and transfer the backup file to the backup folder. Then when you go to the Hassio tab and then snapshots, the backup file will be available there for you to restore it. The other thing that I wanted to mention is about updating Home Assistant. You can update it like you normally would via the Hassio tab. Just press on the update button and it would update to the latest version. You don't need to remove the container and then re-download Hassio to get the newest version of Home Assistant. Last but not least, I want to show you how to manage your Docker containers. There are 2 ways that you can do it. You can use the terminal or by using Portainer, which provides a nice user interface, making it simple to manage all the containers installed. On the terminal, enter the following to create a Docker volume for Portainer. Then enter this command to run Portainer. And that's about it. You can now access Portainer with the server's IP and the port 9000 at the end. When you access Portainer for the first time, it will ask you to create a username and a password. Then after you log in, select local and then click on connect. Now we can see all the containers that are installed and we can either start, stop, or remove containers without having to use a terminal. There are a lot more things that we can do with Portainer. However, to not make this video long, I just wanted to cover the setup process. I would like to cover more about Docker and Portainer on future videos. So if you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments below. All right guys, that's all I have for you today. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. You can also follow me on Twitter and stay in touch. If you like this video and you found it useful, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already, and I will see you in the next video.